לכם בעזרת השם. Today שיעור בעזרת השם is dedicated לרפואה שלמה for the girl מעיינה חיה מושקה בדבורה הדסה. And I have a complete health בעזרת השם, רפואה שלמה, רפואה שלמה, רפואה שלמה בתוך שאר חלמו ישראל. And also בעזרת השם is dedicated לעילוי נשמת הרשל אברהם בן דוד, בנו של עולם ימלא עליו רחמים, יניחנו בגן עדן, תוך שאר נשמות עם ישראל. בעגלה ובזמן קריב, ונאמר אמן. And also, רפואת רפאל יצחק אייזק בן מיכל חיים, מיכאל שלמה בן מיכל, שמעון עוזר בן דינה, נירה חיה, בת שבע.
כן.
שיהיה רפואה שלמה, שמחה שלמה. ושעם ישראל יהיו בריאים ושמחים ומחייכים. So, like we learned, ברוך השם, that we don't know how lucky we are. This thing. Thank you. בעזרת השם. So, רבנו is saying that a man should conquer his יצר הרע. And when he is conquered that yetzer hara, he sees only good things that goes on in his life. He sees only Hashem, only the spiritual side of everything that goes on in his life. And he's developing. Rabbeinu is saying in another place in Likutei Moharan that Shadam Yodea, when a man knows Shekol Moharotav, that all of the things that happens to him in his life, Hem Letovato, are coming from a good reason and supporting him or for him. So that aspect is like to live in the world to come. In the world to come, a man is only climbing, only growing. So if you also know that everything that Hashem is doing to you, he's doing from a good reason, so you're just growing, even from the difficulties, even from your weaknesses, from your failures, you're growing, you're developing, you're learning your lesson. Like that it's written, "En chacham kebal nisayon." There is no wise guy with no experience. You cannot be wise if you don't have an experience. The experience you learn from the fallings. Nimtza, Rabbeinu is saying to us, Nimtza, we can understand now. Ze shekofe et yitzro, that man that conquers his yetzer hara. Haynu shekofe et yemei ra, means that he conquers those bad days. Means that he doesn't see nothing bad in his days. He sees only good. So כשהו מדבר עם האקום, so when he is talking to non-Jews, או שרואה מידותיהם, or that he sees their attributes, אז הי תכף, so then immediately, the bad part of them, the bad ששוכן על הטוב, that lives, that holds himself on the good things, היינו אותיות התורה, means on the letters of the Torah, נתבטל ונופל. Been cancelled and falls down. Even the bad things that he sees, that they have it actually, so to speak, it's disappearing. He sees only good, only good, only good. He sees the benefit of all of it. He sees the result. Like that when Am Israel went to Egypt, they couldn't see nothing bad, nothing good that happened over there. They were just suffering and working so hard, and they were mamash starving, and it was all suffering for them. But after it, we're learning that actually there were sparks over there, and that Am Yisrael had to go to that place and to take them all of that glut, to take all of the spiritual bounty that was hidden over there in Egypt. So now, after taking one step back, we can understand, oh, it was good, it was all good, Baruch Hashem, thank you Hashem. When you're inside the picture, this is the time to. When you're in the situation, this is the time that you need to hold yourself with faith. But if you don't have that faith in during the test, so you're suffering. But if you, like Moshe Rabbeinu wasn't suffering. The ones that have faith, they're not suffering even in the difficult time, even in the hard times. Votiyot haTorah boltin, and then the letters of the Torah are Azai, so then הוא יודע התורה שבאותו הדבר, and then that man, he knows the Torah that's in that thing. A man can learn Torah from situations, from traffic. He learns Torah. from Torah, a certain time that he waits in the bank, and there are certain people that are coming, people goes out, people talking, he learns Torah. He sees Torah through all of the situations. He hears the Hashem Yitbarach talking to him. וזה שכתוב, and this is what it's written בזוהר הקדוש in the Holy Zohar, ברכו השם על אחיו, the angels of Hashem should bless Hashem, גיבורי כוח, hero of power, עושה דברו, the one that listens to, the one that making his words, keeping his words, and the Zohar is explaining, אילין, those are אינון דמתגברין על יצרי הון, those are those ones that conquered their יצר הרע. They've been called now angels, גיבורי כוח, עושה דברו, heroes of powers that keep the words of Hashem יתברך. אינון דמיין למלאכין ממש, the Zohar is saying, those ones look exactly like angels. I read it yesterday, that a man, in ליקוטי הלכות, רבי נתן is explaining that a man, he's got nefesh, spirit, soul, and a body, and he needs to conquer the body under his spirit. The soul gonna control the body, gonna decide. And when he's doing it, when he's achieving it, that he's got 100% control on his body, then his body become to be spiritual. His body become to be in the aspect of a soul, of a nefesh, of a spirit. And it's not physical anymore. Like the Gemara in Masechet Chagiga in the end is saying that the Talmidei Chachamim, they're made out of fire. Avraham Avinu, they threw him to the fire, nothing happened to him. Hananiah, Mishael, Vazariah, they sent them into the fire and nothing happened to them. One of the Avrichim from the Yeshiva, once he was in Rav Berland's house, he came to Rav Berland's and he asked him something about Shalom Bayit. And Rav Berland, instead of answering to him, he saw there was a lighter on the table. He took that lighter, probably with his left hand, light it, put his finger on inside to the fire, and told him, a man should check himself every day where he's holding in Kedusha. Every day he should check himself where he's holding in Kedusha. The Gemara is telling us stories like that. If a man doesn't believe the Gemara, or he thinks that it was only in the generation of the Gemara, why? If a man conquers his Yetzer Hara today, so he becomes to be like the righteous Mimon and people in the generation of the Gemara. Rav Shalom said, Rav Berland gonna sit in heaven between Tanaim and Amoraim, he will not have nothing to be embarrassed about. Nothing. No doubt about it. Why to be embarrassed? They were crying that they don't want to come in this generation, and we can understand them, we know why they're crying. Why they were crying. It's a very hard generation. And if you're closing your eyes in a generation like that, you're even stronger. It's very easy to serve Hashem Yitbarach. It's very obvious that you're going to serve Hashem Yitbarach when Beit HaMikdash was only maybe 20, 50, 70, 200 years ago. Beit HaMikdash, they could see the ruin of Beit HaMikdash. And also the beginning of the Tanaim that were in the generation of the destruction. So it was obvious that you're going to serve Hashem Yitbarach when you have Beit HaMikdash, the Kohanim, sacrificing, Korbanot, and you were coming for the holidays, and everyone are talking, it's Avodat Hashem. You can see the cloud, Hashem revealed himself, the name of Hashem Yitbarach inside of the Azara. So it's obvious you're going to serve Hashem Yitbarach. It's not such a big deal that there was that Amor Tanaim and Amoraim. They were huge also in that generation, no doubt about it. But you see hundreds of them. Actually, there were thousands of them. Talmidei Chachamim, huge, very holy. In this generation, let's see you serve Hashem Yitbarach. Let's see you close your eyes. But if you're going to do that, Ma'ayin lo ra'ata Elokim zulatecha. Who can understand? Who can evaluate? Who can understand how much you have? How much you're gaining? The Zohar is saying, the Gemara is saying that if a man is guarding his eyes, I think the Zohar HaKadosh is saying that, if a guy that is not married, he's guarding his eyes in a city, so HaKadosh Baruch Hu has got a picture of him, and he's kissing that picture every day, and saying, this is my son that is guarding his eyes in a city. In a city, you cannot guard your eyes. The difficulty is very hard. A single guy that is not married, guarding his eyes in a city, so many women, so many difficulties. married guy who is 70 years old is gotten question. Yes, let's see you guard your eyes in the yeshiva. Let's see you not looking on people's iPhones, on people's sandwiches. Let's see you. Talking about big tests, not to look at women, huh? It's a big test. It's not a test at all. You know why it's not a test at all? Because it all depends on your will. If you want to look at women, you're going to look at women. Nothing going to stop you. Nothing. And if your wife can stand, walk with you, and you're going to look at women while you're walking with you. If this is your desire, if this is your lust, you cannot stop yourself. You don't have no control in yourself. But if you don't want to look at women, so it's not a test at all. You're just not looking. It all depends on your will. בדרך שבה אדם רוצה ללך, מוליכין אותו. If you want to look at women, you're looking at women. If you don't want to look at women, you don't look at women. If now I want to lift it in my hand, this is it. If I don't want to lift it, am I going to lift it? No. Just when I want it to be here, so I'm going to hold it here. If I want it to be here, I'm going to do it. Nothing. You cannot do nothing without having a will. The will, this is the power that makes you do things. If you want to look at women, you're going to look at women. But if you don't, so you're not gonna. And if you're still looking, so don't tell stories that you don't want to. The truth is that you want to. You enjoy, and it's exciting you, and it's, I don't know what, gives you, and you're doing it because this is what that you want. But if you want to think about Hashem Yitbarach, you're gonna close your eyes. You're closing your eyes. Like I told you that I made long it bodedut a few weeks ago at night, and I was praying and guarding my eyes, and I said to myself, you're a liar. You're praying on guarding your eyes with your eyes open. You have to lie. It have to be a lie. If you're saying, Ribono Shel Olam, help me to guard my eyes, help me to guard my eyes, and you're looking everywhere, so it have to be that you're lying. Help me to guard my eyes means help me to guard them. What's the problem? All right, now, oh, thank you, Hashem. This is it. You're praying that in 3 months from now, Hashem going to help you to guard your eyes? Why? Why not now? What you want? You don't want to guard your eyes, so don't pray on that. You want to be a millionaire? Pray on money. You want to have a BMW? Pray on a BMW. No problems. It's all allowed. It's not a problem. Pray on what that you're on your level, on your truth, from your heart. Words that gonna come out from your heart gonna be accepted. If you want money, pray on money. Rav Shalom said, a man that gonna dedicate 1 hour every day to have parnasa, or to have money, not only that he's going to have parnasa, he's going to have enough money to give support other people to have parnasa also. 1 hour! Waste 1 hour of your life every day to talk about money. Why I'm telling waste? Because Hashem Yitbarach is going to give you the money even if you're not going to pray. So why you need to pray on money? If you want to pray on money, you need to pray on confidence. You need to pray on faith, not on money. Money, if you deserve, Hashem is going to give you. If Hashem, you have a tikkun to receive money, you're going to receive money. You don't need to pray on money. It's like to pray on money that you're going to have money to go to Uman. And then in the last day, Borei Olam is going to tell you, you have all of the money and you cannot go. You can decide, I'm going to do this and that. In the last moment, you're not able to do. Because you need to pray on the issue itself. You need to pray on the merit to support Talmidei Chachamim. You need to pray on the merit to support Hafatzah. Not to pray on money. You mean money, money, money. What's money? Money, it's nothing. Money, it's imaginations. Rabbeinu asked once, what happened with all of the coins that people were making through all of the generations? Where are they? Where are them, all of the money? Where all the coins went? In every generation, people making money, more. Where is it? Where it's all going? It's an illusion. It's not exist. It's imaginations. Need to pray on the merit, on the spiritual source of the things that you want to achieve. So Rabbeinu is saying, the man that have that power, that he conquers his Yetzer Hara, and like that we said, slowly, slowly, day by day, another 1 hour it bodedut, another half an hour it bodedut. Haynu shekofet yemei hara, means that he's canceling the bad side of the days. He's looking only on the good. So when he's looking on non-Jews, on other situations, he sees only the Torah that it contains. He sees the source of life, of everything, of everything. You're looking at non-Jews. We had few guys that came here that were non-Jews. What? You saw a different? You saw something bad in them? They were all very cute, very nice, were listening and come to understand and to learn, very curious to understand, to learn about Judaism. What's the problem? Can you say something wrong with him? You don't know nothing. We don't have those eyes that can define, that can say, no, he's a non-Jew, he's a Jew. You don't know nothing. Everyone are smiling, everyone are good. Now, in those moments, Rav Shalom in South Africa gives a class to 10,000 non-Jews or 15,000 non-Jews. The priest, Philip, invited Rav Shalom to come to give a shiur. And he came and he's giving a shiur over there. 10,000 people, 15,000 people.
Lashir.
Huge shiur, an amazing shiur. What?
Rav Hornstein. Lashir.
Yes. Right? Right? So, when a man conquers his own Yetzirah, he doesn't see no bad in someone else. If you have something bad inside of yourself, this is why you're judging other people and criticizing them. If you're cheap, you're looking at other people and you think, ah, oh, this man is a very cheap man. If you're angry and vicious, you look at him and you say, oh, he's so cruel, he's so vicious, that man. Because you recognize it from yourself. But if you're all good, you see only good at people. You don't see no bad. You purified yourself, you purified your eyes. And this is it, and your eyes see who that you are. If you're looking only for good, you're going to see only good. And if you're looking for bad, because you're bad, you see only bad. And you have complaints and fears and anxieties and thousands of complaints. Azay techef, so then immediately all of the bad that covers the good, means that covers the letters of the Torah, been cancelled and false. And the letters of the Torah, six up, out. Azayu yodea, and then the man knows the Torah that's in that thing. This is what's written in the Zohar, like we said before, that those people that conquers their own Yetzirah, they become to be like angels. Damyan, inun damyan lemalachin mamash, oseh devaro. And what it means that they look like angels, that they listen to the words of Hashem. De'avdin lehay davar, that they are making those things happen. Lishmoa bekol devaro, that people are going to have the ability to hear, to listen to the voice of Hashem. You, by listening to Hashem, you're building a bridge for other people to listen to. Like Rabbeinu explained it, how the voice is being heard. One part of air is heating another part of air, and that part of air is heating another part, and the voice is passing like a rumor. I'm telling you something, and you're telling him, and he's telling him, and this is how it goes. So if now you are working on yourself to bring Hashem into your life, and now you believe in Hashem Yitbarach, so you created a new base for Hashem Yitbarach, a new place, a new Dalet Amot for Hashem Yitbarach to be in. So the ones that are your neighbors, now they can know Hashem Yitbarach also. And if they're going to work on themselves also, so also their neighbors going to be able to see Hashem. And this is how we're distributing the light. This is how we're making it wider and wider, by working on ourselves. By working on ourselves. To cancel all fears and anxieties. By giving power to the husks, not to believe on bad things, not to be afraid of things, have to have that courage to confront, to deal. If you're afraid to go in the middle of the night, you have to try. Yeah, so for you it's too much to go to the desert in the middle of the night. All right, but go out to your backyard, go to the park, go to the street, to some place that there are lamps over there. Start to talk to Hashem Yitbarach on your fear. Tell him, Ribono Shel Olam, why should I be afraid so much from people? Who can touch me? No one can touch me. If you see that you become so, mamash, it's an anxiety for you and you cannot function and you lost your hitbodedut, so don't do that. All right, but start working on it to break fears and anxieties. There's nothing to be afraid of. There is nothing to be afraid of because there is nothing except of Hashem. And if Hashem wants a man to die, a man can die in his sleep. He doesn't need to take you out. Hashem doesn't need to take you out to beat you. He can beat you in your house, in your bed, when you're eating. He doesn't need to beat you outside. Come outside. He doesn't need to tell you that. He can beat you in the Beit Midrash if he wants. Lishma bekol devaro inun zachyan lemishma kalin mil ela. Those have the merit to hear voices from above. How do you hear those voices? Inside their life. They realize the reality. They see Hashem Yitbarach in the details. They just see Hashem. And they understand. They hear voice from above. It doesn't have to be a voice. It can come as a voice also, but if you understand what Hashem wants from you, this is the best voice of them all. I asked once Rav Shalom a very simple question, and he answered to me, Mamash, so amazing picture. I told him, Rav, now I realize, maybe 2 years ago, I realized that the salvation gonna come through nature, inside of the nature. It will not gonna be spiritual at all, the process. When gonna be the salvation, it's gonna be miracles. But all of the process, Hashem wants it to be with no miracles. Hashem wants it to go through nature. For me, it was a new understanding. For Rav, it was obvious that this is the will of Hashem. To cancel the free choice from people, this is something that Hashem can do in a minute. It's not a problem. He just makes a huge voice, and this is it. He just need to... That Hashem was, he's just looking on the earth and it's all shaking. This is it. Earthquake. One earthquake. And Hashem just need to... It's nothing he doesn't need to do. And everyone gonna surrender and everyone gonna scream to Hashem. Hashem can do it in a minute. It's not a problem. It's not the will of Hashem. Hashem wants us to choose Torah, choose Kedusha, choose Tefillah. For that he cannot break nature. For that he cannot cancel the nature. So it's our work, our effort to conquer all of nature, all of the darkness, all of the bad that this world contains, to force it to be good. Through our prayers, through our ishtadluyot, through our classes, our conversations between friends, more tefillot and more prayers. And this is how Hashem wants it to be. This is how Hashem wants it to be. And we need to convince Hashem, we need to push Hashem, and we need to convince Hashem and to force Hashem to bring the salvation. We need to hold Him tight and to tell Him, this is it, now you bring the salvation. How can it be, Hashem, that you haven't brought it yet? So many people are suffering, so many people doesn't have houses, so many people doesn't have parnasah. Please, Ribono Shel Olam, please. Hashem wants us to talk. It's not that He cannot do it in one day, He can and He wants to. But He wants it to grow through us, from inside. That we're going to have the merit on the salvation. That the salvation is going to be because of our actions. Not because that He saved the world. He can save it in a minute. It's not a problem. He wants us to save the world. He wants us to convince all of the world to serve Hashem Yitbarach. Even though, and we need to remember that always, that even though that it looks the darkest, so what? The light that comes down also is the brightest. It's the best. It's the most beautiful light that there is. Who can have Shalom Bayit without those amazing advice? Who can have Shalom Bayit without those advice? The most gentle person in the world will not gonna have Shalom Bayit. The most quiet man, the most gentle one, caring one. He will not gonna have Shalom Bayit. He will not gonna have, because you need to have someone that's gonna explain to you things that you don't have the ability to understand by yourself. And even if you have a heart and you have a will and you... There are people that are bigger than you. And you have to accept it. And yet, this is what it calls humility. You have to accept that there is someone that is better than you. Really. And to accept it just like that. And not to find excuses and answers. There is someone that is righteous, that is holy, that is in a total different place than us. And he's better than us. And we have to accept it. And we have to love him and to support him and to understand that he's like you working in a certain factory or something like that. You have to understand that there is a boss, and you're not it. You're not the boss. And you're not going to be the boss. It's not your job to be the boss. You want to stay in your job. You want to cooperate. You want to grow. You need to understand that there is a boss. Not to want to replace him from the first step, and not even in the last step. If he will inherit it to you, if he will give you more responsibilities and going to let you open a business for yourself, no problems. But first of all, if you want to be loyal, you need to be happy that Hashem is Hashem, that Moshe Rabbeinu is Moshe Rabbeinu. Not only because that Moshe, I don't have no contest with him because he already passed away. There is a righteous man in this generation that you need not to argue with him. That he is that he owns the base with everything, the world that Abur Olam gave him. Like Rabbeinu, when he was alive, he said, Mate Elokim Biyadi. I have the staff of Elokim, of Moshe Rabbeinu, of Avraham Avinu. He was holding it. Means that he controlled the creation. There is a righteous man in every generation that he controls the creation. Like that I told you that we heard from Rav Mordechai Eliyahu that he said on Rav Kook, on Rav Berland, that they are holding Mashiach back, and that Rav Shalom himself that is said that he's holding Mashiach back, that he will not gonna come. And so those righteous people, they have those powers. We don't. We don't know. We never saw Mashiach. We don't know who is Mashiach. We don't know nothing. We don't know who we are. How are we going to know is Mashiach? You can recognize Mashiach. You don't know who you are. You don't recognize yourself. You don't know that you're a holy neshama. You don't know. Fighting with yourself on your attributes like it's you. It's your attributes. It's not you. If you're saying, I'm hungry, I'm tired, you don't know what you're talking about. You're never hungry. You're never tired. Rabbi Zusha was saying, my body is tired. Zusha Raev. Zusha is hungry. Not me. Me? I'm Neshama Elokit. I never tired. I never hungry. I just want Hashem. Rav Shalom said it's not allowed to go to sleep. It's not allowed to go to sleep. It's a prohibition to go to sleep. To go to sleep, it's not allowed. So how are you going to sleep? How you can see Rav Shalom sleeps once in a while. So how can it be? He said, you can want Hashem Yitbarach, and while you want Hashem Yitbarach, if you fell asleep, so you fell asleep. But you cannot decide, all right, this is it for me, this day it was enough, now I'm going to sleep. You cannot think like that. Those are bad thoughts. You don't want to deal, you don't want to serve Hashem Yitbarach anymore. This is it was enough for you. It's not a good thought. A good thought, I want Hashem. My body doesn't have no more powers anymore. I cannot do no more itbodeduyot, not to learn Torah. My body have to rest a little bit. Great. But as long as your neshama always attaches herself to Hashem Yitbarach, and then your sleep is going to be totally different. One time Rabbeinu asked one of these students, he asked him, how you slept today? And that student didn't know what to answer to him. And then Rabbeinu told him, I was sleeping b'inyan iter yad, on the subject of left hand, on left hand. Means that while he was going to sleep, he was sleeping on a certain issue. He was serving Hashem Yitbarach during his sleep. Alach lishon b'inyan iter yad. He went to sleep on the issue of left hand. This is how he was sleeping. So he wasn't sleeping. He was aware to himself. In Likutei Tefilot Rabbi Natan, Rav Shalom said it a lot of times, that a man should pray that he's going to serve Hashem Yitbarach while he's asleep. Not to forget you, not when I'm eating, not when I'm sleeping, not to forget Hashem. It's a concept, it's something, it's an option. Not to forget Hashem Yitbarach when you're asleep. So of course you need to pray on that, and you have to say Kriyat Shema with all of your heart before, and not to eat too much before, that you're not going to faint. Need to go to sleep in a certain holy way. Like Rav Shalom said, if you're going to sleep like a lion, you're going to wake up like a lion. If you go to sleep like a dog, you're going to wake up like a dog. It all depends on how you're going to sleep. Dead tired. You're going to wake up dead tired. Actually, Rav Shalom said also sleep, it's an illusion. On the moment that you went to sleep, this is the moment that you woke up. For you, what happened? You went to sleep, immediately you woke up. Nothing happened for you. 8 hours, 12 hours, 16 hours for you. You went to sleep and you woke up. Nothing happened, right? Where all of those hours went? You went to sleep and you woke up. This is what it happened. You closed your eyes, you disappeared, and now you opened your eyes again. This is what it happened. All of those hours on hours on hours of sleep. What were you doing all of those hours? Where have you been? You waste your life. So for sure, you don't have the ability not. Your body, he used to sleep 7 hours, 8 hours. Me, for an example, I know on myself that in the time that I'm used to wake up in the morning, I'm waking up. It doesn't matter if I went to sleep for 4 hours or for 7 hours or for 3 hours, I'm waking up in the moment that I'm used to wake up. And if I'm going to put my alarm for half an hour before, when I'm going to wake up half an hour before, I'm going to be dead tired. I can work on myself until I'm going to get used to that, and then that's going to be my time. But it doesn't matter for me how much time I'm asleep. I have a certain moment that I can open my eyes in that moment. And before that, I cannot. Why you cannot? Why are you so tired? Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu, He didn't gave you the soul back. If you have all of your soul inside of your body, you have all of your powers. But if Hashem didn't give all of the soul back into all of, He didn't charge your battery full, so you don't have a full battery. And if it's only half, and Hashem can decide that 6 hours will not going to be enough for you, and for you it's going to be like that you haven't slept at all, and in the last 5 minutes He's going to give you the power. You can see that sometimes you're waking up and you have to go back to sleep, and you're closing your eyes, and after 10 minutes you wake up all perfect. How can it be? All night it wasn't charging, last 5 minutes gave it all, because your neshama is in the hand of Hashem. And with that understanding, you need to go to sleep and to say Kriyat Shema Mamash with tears. Ribono Shel Olam, please, I'm going to sleep now. I don't know what's going to be with me. My soul is going up to heaven, and who knows what's going to be in that trial. If you're going to decide to send it back to me, or if Chas Shalom not, I don't know. If it's going to come dressed with wonderful garments, spiritual light that's going to surround it, or that it's going to come back tired and hungry and angry. A man can wake up in the morning like demon, and he doesn't know why. There's no reason for that. And he's just so full with angers and frustrations. It's the result of the trial that you had in the night, that you're not aware of that trial at all. This is why we need to pray on everything, to beg, please Ribono Shel Olam, that my sleep gonna help me, that my eating gonna help me. There are sparks in food, in drinks, in everything, in fruits. You know which sparks? You can eat something, gonna make you calm and relax. You can eat something and after the meal, you're all angry, you don't know what's going on with you. So please, Ribono Shel Olam, give me the right food, give me the right sparks, things that I need, that I'm going to say the brachot with all of my heart. Even if you decided to say the brachot, you don't know if it's going to work or not going to work. You need to pray on the brachot. Like in the beginning of Shmona Esrei, we're asking, Ribono Shel Olam, before of praying, I'm coming to pray and I'm asking from Hashem Midoach, please, Hashem Sfatai Tiftach, open my lips. Yes. On something that is so pure, what am I going to do now? I'm going to say Baruch, Ata, Hashem, Elokeinu, Veloke Avotenu, Eloke Avraham. I'm praising Hashem. On that I need to ask permission? Yes. Because you need to know that you cannot do nothing without the help of Hashem. Nothing. Even the best things of them all. You want to bring the salvation. You want to do only Hafatzai. You want to give charity. You want to save people's life. You need to have approval from HaKadosh Baruch Hu for that. Fix me. Approval from HaKadosh Baruch Hu for that. It's not your world. It's Hashem Yitbarach. He's Borei Olam. He's the Creator. And not you. Ki HaTorah Nikret Davar. Because the Torah, we're calling it Davar. Davar is a thing. And also, it's like words, dvarim. Kemo shekatuv, like that it's written, davar tziva le'elef dor, that HaKadosh Baruch Hu commanded 1,000 generations in the obligations of the Torah. V'chol ma she'otiyot ha'Torah nitztamtzem, and as much as the letters of the Torah constrict, ve'nitlabshim, and cover themselves betzimtzumim, constrictions, uvilvushim yeterim, and with more coverings, hatorahu, so then the torahu is behelem, missing more, disappears more, uvitkasya yoter, and more covered, umishem afshit et haotiyot hatorah me'alevushim, and the man that undresses, that removes those coverings from the letters of the Torah, who domeh, he looks like that one, shebone et haTorah, that he's building the Torah, he's bringing it to be exist, back to reality, back to people's life. Lemashal, for an example, otiyot haTorah, the letters of the Torah, shayu mefuzarin, that were spread, umeforadim, and separated, מפורדין בלשונות הארקום, in the languages of non-Jews, the nations, ולא היה שום אדם יודע מהם, and there was no man that knew about them. People are talking English, people are talking French, they don't realize that part of the words that they're using are coming from the holy language, from Lashon HaKodesh. They're not aware, they speak their own language. מחמת הימי רע, why people don't know? Because of the bad days שהחשיך עליהם והלביש אותם, that made darkness on those letters and covered them. וכשבא זה האדם, and when that man is coming, שהוא דומה למלאך השם צבאות, צבאות, that he looks like an angel of השם יתברך, by that, על ידי שכופה את יצרו, that he conquers his יצר הרע, היינו הימי רע, means his bad days, אזי, so then, הרע, the bad, היינו לשונות העקום, the languages, נכפפין ונתבטלין כנגדו, they're bending themselves and canceling themselves in front of him, to him. ואז נשארין, and then stays only אותיות התורה, the letters of the Torah, בולטין. בולטין, stand out. וכשנפשטין מהלבושים הגשמיים, and when there have been נפשטין, stripped from the physical coverings, היינו מלשונות העקום, from the languages of the non-Jews, היינו ממידות רעות, from the bad attributes, like we talked about it, and we said that inside the languages of the nations been dressed the attributes of that nation. One nation is wrapped kruchim after one last, and one nation more after a second last, and they're all mamash, that nation chased more after money, and that after other lusts and desires, and you can hear it in the language that there is one language that push you to make money, and one push you to violence, and one push you to other things. Haynu mimera means that they're receiving their power of bad attributes from the bad days. Bad days means that they don't believe that there is good inside of those days, like we said. Azai, so then, mekablin elu otiyot ha-Torah, so those letters of the Torah receives or rav yoter mima shayu mekablin mitchila. Now, when that man is coming and he reveals those letters, so those letters reveals a lot more light than they had from the beginning. כי מתחילה, because in the beginning, לא היו מקבלים אלא כדי חיות, they were receiving only enough light to give life, הראוי that fits, in an amount that gonna fit to that place, לאותו מקום, כדי שלא להשפיע יותר מהראוי להם, because הקדוש ברוך הוא didn't want to influence for them more than they're able to use, and not to damage themselves. כמו שכתוב בכתבי הארי, like that it's written in the handwrites of the הארי הקדוש, עדלו ידע, until the man cannot recognize, בין ארור המן לברוך מרדכי, that he will not going to have the difference between damned המן to blessed מרדכי, means, היינו, שימשיך שפע להקליפות, that a man can bring שפע, bounty, to the husks, כדי חיונו ולא יותר, enough that they're going to live, and not more than that. So Rabbeinu is bringing to us here Kabbalah. By Pshat, it means that that place, only in Purim we're allowed to come to that place of Arur Haman. The balanced place is Arur Haman, damned Haman, and blessed Mordechai. This is the right place. This is normal, regular life. But in Purim, that now we're in the eve of Purim, Chodesh Adar, in Purim, it's all changed. Only in Purim you have the ability to say blessed Haman and damned Mordechai. Means that you can give more bounty even to the husks, even to the darkness, and you're not afraid. You know that Mordechai is with you, and you know that the righteous man is with you. You're not afraid. You're not afraid that all of the world is surrounding you. You're not afraid of nothing. Mordechai is standing alone. Even the people from Am Israel were arguing with Mordechai. Even after the salvation, Mordechai didn't have a complete picture. Ratzui l'rov echav. Only most of Am Yisrael were supporting him. We need that righteous to come, that all of the world is going to love him. This is going to be Mashiach. That all of the world is going to follow him. All of the world is going to support him, going to love him, going to respect him. No one going to disagree with him. No one going to argue with him. It's going to be Mashiach. So it's explained it over there. שצריכים להמשיך חיות להקדושה, that we need to pull life to the side of קדושה, הנעלמת that disappears, the קדושה that disappears inside of the husk, inside, בתוך הקליפות, אבל צריכים להמשיך החיות בצמצום גדול, but you have to pull light in a very constricted way. שזהו סוד כוונות השחרות של פורים, עיין שם, that this is the secret of how to drink in פורים, you can look over there. Aval, but when you undress those letters of the Torah from all of the husks, כשנפשטין האותיות מהקליפות, אזי מקבלין אור רב מלאלה. So then they're receiving huge amounts of light from above. And this is what it means, that it's written, this is what it's written, עושה דברו לשמוע בכל דברו. They're keeping his words to listen to his words. כשעושינו בונין להתורה, when people are building the letters of the Torah, שהיה מתחילה, that was in the beginning, it was מפוזרין ומפורדין, spread and separated, בלשונות האקום, in the languages of the non-Jews, and in bad attributes, ובימרה, and in במידות רעות, ובימרה, in bad days and in bad attributes, as I so then, when you're separating the good from the bad, when you look and you see good things inside of bad situations, and you're looking, investigating to find Hashem, so then as I, you have the merit, לשמוע בכל דברו, to hear the voice of the words of Hashem, וזוכין למשמע קלין מלאלה, you have the merit to hear voices from heaven, from above. היינו, it means שהדבר, that thing, היינו התורה, means the Torah, מקבלין אוריו מלמעלה, receives a lot of light from above. וזה שמיעת התורה, and this is why a man have to listen to the Torah, to hear קריאת התורה, to listen to the Torah. And you can hear the Torah talks to you during the day. You can hear the Torah talking to you and convincing you to serve Hashem. וזה בחינת נעשה ונשמע, and this is that aspect of we'll do and we're going to hear. שמתחילה עושינו בונין לאותיות התורה, that in the beginning, first of all, you should do and you should build the letters of the Torah. שיהיה אותיות בולטות ומצטרפות, that the letters are going to be upstand, sticking up, ומצטרפות and joins. ואחר כך, and after it, נשמע, we can hear. זכין למשמע קלין מלאלה, you have the merit to hear voices from above. היינו שאותיות התורה, means that the letters of the Torah, מקבלים חיות, receives life, ואור רב יותר ממה שקיבלו מתחילה, more light than they were receiving from the beginning, כשהיו מלובשים בלשונות הגויים ובימרה, and from the days that they were covered in the languages of the non-Jews and in the bad days. Means that when you look and finally you realize, you find a certain point in those languages that is illuminating, you can achieve from it a lot more than it been used inside of that language. For you, it's going to be a conclusion for your Avodat Hashem, going to push you closer to Hashem Yitbarach, means going to be a lot higher. For them, for an example, now you have the word in English, earth. Earth is exactly like Eretz. It's the same word, earth and Eretz, it's the same word. For them, it means earth. This is what they can do with it. But for us, you can see with it, for an example, the most simple example, you can see Hashem. You're getting closer to Hashem Yitbarach by seeing that. You can see, so your faith in Chachamim is getting stronger and stronger. So it becomes to be a lot more than just the word earth. It's also Hashem Yitbarach and the righteous people and the power of the Gemara Kedosha and how they knew it. And you're getting stronger and you achieve a lot more than they had when they had that word been used in their language. For them it was just earth, Eretz, all right. For us it's all connection to Hashem Yitbarach and faith and Emunat Chachamim and on and on. Avoy Sai, Shabbat Shalom.